then what are loose packed structures. In that close packed structures, there are two examples, hexagonal close packed structure represented by SCP and face centered cubic structure which is FCC. Simple crystal structures. So these are basic crystal structures. They are either monoatomic or contain simple bases. These crystal structures are made up of single kind of atoms, that is they are monoatomic or they contain simple bases. I suppose you remember what is meant by basis. There are two types of crystal structures. They are close packed structures and loose packed structure. So these simple crystal structures can be divided into two categories. They can be studied into two categories, close packed structure and loose packed structures. We will study one by one. What is a close packed structure? Such structures are found in monoatomic crystals having non-directional bonding, such as metallic bonding. So such structures are found in monoatomic crystals, crystals made up of single kind of atoms and also having non-directional bonding, such as metallic bonding. So atoms and molecules in a crystal or solids or liquids are bound to each other by certain kinds of bonds. Mainly there are five different kinds of bonds: ionic bond, covalent bond, metallic bond, hydrogen bond and van der Waals bond, isn't it? Some bonds are directional kind of bonds, like covalent bond, which is a directional kind of bond, isn't it? So this close packed structures are mainly found in monoatomic crystals having non-directional bonding. This bonding details of the bonding or bonds, we are going to study in the second unit, isn't it? So till then you just remember that close packed structures are found in monoatomic crystals having non-directional bonding, such as metallic bonding. In such structures, the coordination number of each atom is 12, isn't it? So coordination number, the number of atoms surrounding each atom is called as coordination number. So each atom is surrounded by 12 equal sized neighbors. So in closed packed structure, each atom is surrounded by 12 atoms. Each atom is surrounded by 12 equal sized neighbors. That is what is the meaning of coordination number, isn't it? In order to form a closed packed structure, there should be coordination number should be 12, isn't it? So how these 12 atoms are arranged? Out of these 12 neighbors, 6 lie in a plane. If you consider a single atom at the center, 6 atoms are surrounding this atom in a plane. 6 atoms are surrounding this atoms in a plane, isn't it? Then 3 in adjacent plane. In a plane, above this plane, the central atom is surrounded by 3 atoms. And 3 atoms in a similar plane below that plane, isn't it? So you just try to consider a plane at the center, central plane, having an atom at the center, which is surrounded by 6 equal sized neighbors, that is a middle plane. Above this plane, that central atom is surrounded by 3 atoms. Below the central plane, the central atom is surrounded by again 3 atoms. So the central atom is surrounded by 6 equal sized neighbors. This is what is the meaning of close packed structure or coordination number. For a close packed structure, the coordination number should be 12. There are two types of close packed structures: hexagonal close packed structure, which is abbreviated as SCP, and face-centered cubic close-packed structure, abbreviated as FCC, isn't it? So we will study first what is a hexagonal closed packed structure or HCP structure. A layer arrangement is shown in the figure. Each atom is surrounded by six equal sized neighbors in a plane. You can see in the figure, there is a central atom, isn't it? Shown by white circles. Shown by white circle. You consider an atom at the center, which is surrounded by six equal sized neighbors. Six equal sized neighbors, isn't it? So, these atoms are forming certain valleys. These atoms are forming certain valleys, isn't it? Above this plane, that central atom is surrounded by three atoms, which are shown by dark circles, which are shown by dark circle, which are designated by layer B, isn't it? layer A, white circles, layer B, dark circles, and C, which are the valleys formed by central plane, formed by the central plane. Okay, so a layer arrangement is shown in figure. Each atom is surrounded by six equal sized neighbors in one plane. Another layer B can be placed on the top of layer A such that each atom of B layer occupy alternate valleys formed by A layer, shown by dark circle. You can see that the dark circles are occupying the positions of alternate valleys, formed by A layer, So there are six valleys formed by A layer around the central atom. So on the alternate valleys, the atoms of B layer are occupying their position. So there are remaining again three valleys. Three valleys are occupied by B layer of atoms, and three valleys are vacant, which are shown by C, isn't it? So this is the second layer, central layer having an atom at the center surrounded by six equal sized neighbors forming alternate valleys, six valleys. On the alternate valleys in the second plane, the atoms of B layer are occupying the alternate valleys, positions of alternate valleys formed by A layer, isn't it? So this is B layer. The third layer of atoms is placed on B layer of atoms. First layer, second layer, and above that there is a third layer. Third layer of atoms is placed on B layer of atoms such that B layer exactly overlaps atoms of A layer. B layer of atoms exactly overlap A layer. This type of stacking is repeated. It is called SCP stacking. Stacking means arrangement, keeping some things systematically. You can see the stacking in case of library. We keep the books in the stacks very systematically so that we can find it at the proper time without losing much of our time. So that is a kind of keeping the things, so which is called as stacking. Here also the arrangement of atoms is called as stacking. This type of stacking is repeated. It is called as SCP stacking. Can be represented by ABAB, isn't it? AB, A layer of atoms, then above that there is a B layer of atoms, then A layer of, third layer of atoms is A. The third layer of atoms, atoms in the third layer are exactly over the atoms of A layer, isn't it? Exactly over atoms of first layer, So this type of stacking is repeated, which is called as ABAB layer, ABAB kind of stacking. The shape of the conventional unit cell is hexagonal, which is shown in the figure. there are 12 atoms located at the corners. You can see there are 12 atoms located at the corners, two at the center of basal planes. There are two basal planes at the ground level and at the top level. So at the center of these two basal planes, there are two atoms. So two at the center of basal planes and three completely inside the hexagon forming part of B layer. So B layer is shown, there are three atoms which are shown by a triangle, that are the B layer of atoms, isn't it? Lower a basal plane forms A layer of atoms. There is a central atom surrounded by six atoms forming an hexagon. B layer of atoms is shown by a triangle, and again there is a layer of atoms which is forming the upper plane, which is the top plane, isn't it? Again there is a atom at the center which is surrounded by six equal sized neighbors. So from this figure also you can understand the stacking arrangement. You can imagine the stacking arrangement, isn't it? ABAB type, isn't it? So there are 12 atoms located at the corners, two at the center of basal planes, and three completely inside the hexagon forming part of B layer. The effective number of atoms in a unit cell is 12 × 1/6. 12 × 1/6. Why 1/6? Each atom is shared by six such type of hexagons. That is why we are dividing it by 1/6. In the previous video we have studied how to find out the effective number of lattice points per unit cell. So 12 × 1/6 plus 2 × 1/2. Why we are multiplying it by 1/2? There are two atoms at the center of basal planes, that is why we are 2, then multiplied by 1/2. That central atom is shared by two hexagons, isn't it? That is why we are multiplying it by 1/2. Plus 3 for what? 3 for the atoms located at the middle portion, at the center of the hexagon. They are not shared by any other unit cell. They are exclusively part of that particular unit cell. So it is 3. That is why it comes out to be 2 + 2 + 1 + 3, isn't it? 2 + 1 + 3, isn't it? So the interatomic distance for the atoms within a layer is suppose A, isn't it? So in the lower portion it is shown the distance between the two atoms is shown by A, which is equal to 2r. You can see it. So it is A is equal to 2r, and the distance between adjacent layers, so length of the unit cell is represented by C. A to A, the distance is C, isn't it? And the distance between the two adjacent layer, the atoms in the middle portion and the atoms in the lower portion, the distance between them is C/2, where C is the height of the unit cell. For ideal SCP, C is equal to 1.66633a. There is a relation between the C and A. C is height of the unit cell, A is the distance between the adjacent atoms, isn't it? A is the interatomic distance. So the relation in a SCP structure is C is equal to 1.633a, isn't it? So the number of atoms per hexagon type of structure comes out to be 2 + 1 + 3 is equal to 6, isn't it? 2 + 1 + 3 is equal to 6. The shaded portion represents the primitive cell. Again, we will see the shaded portion. In this figure, there is a shaded portion, and the hexagon is made up of three such type of shaded portion. three such type of portion. So this shaded portion is a primitive cell, isn't it? So I hope you remember what is meant by a primitive cell. So the shaded portion represents the primitive cell. It contains two atoms instead of one because of the presence of the bases. Because of the presence of the bases, in the middle part of the shaded portion, there is an atom. So effective number of atoms per primitive cell in this case is two. So three such primitive cells from a hexagonal type of structure. So 2 plus 2 plus 2 is equal to 6, isn't it? So the effective number of atoms per hexagon type of structure per unit cell is 6, and the effective number of atoms per primitive cell is 2, isn't it? Because the hexagon type of structure is made up of three such type of primitive cells. The volume of primitive cell is 1/3 of volume of the hexagonal cell. The volume of primitive cell is 1/3 of volume of hexagonal cell. It is obvious, isn't it? So three such type of primitive cells form a hexagonal type of structure. So the volume of the primitive cell is 1/3 of volume of hexagonal cell. Now let us define what is meant by a packing fraction or packing efficiency. The packing fraction or packing efficiency is defined as the ratio of volume occupied by atoms in the unit cell to total volume of the unit cell. It is the ratio. Ratio of what? Volume occupied by atoms in the unit cell. Volume occupied by atoms in the unit cell to total volume of the unit cell. So just imagine there is a box in the type of a cube, isn't it? A cubical box, a box in the type of a cube, isn't it? And if you fill up that box with some balls, equal sized balls, isn't it? Let R is the radius of each ball, and if you fill up this box with say 10 number of balls, the box is filled with 10 number of balls. What is the volume of the box? If A is the side of the cube, volume of the cube is A cube. Volume of the cube is A cube. And how many number of balls are there in the cube? The number of balls in the cube are 10. If R is the radius of each ball, volume of each ball is equal to 4/3 pi r cube. 4/3 pi r cube. So 4/3 pi r cube is the volume of one ball. What will be the volume of 10 balls? 10 × 4/3 pi r cube. This is how this is the 10 × 4/3 pi r cube is the volume occupied by the balls in the box, isn't it? Then what is the volume of the box? A cube, where A is the side of the cube, isn't it? This is how we can imagine the packing fraction. Packing fraction is the ratio of volume occupied by atoms in the unit cell to the total volume of the unit cell. Now you can tell me what is the packing fraction in the SCP kind of structure or a primitive cell. So it is represented by F. F is equal to 2 × 4/3 pi r cube. F is equal to 2 × 4/3 pi r cube. 4/3 pi r cube is the volume of a single atom of radius r. Why we are multiplying it by 2? We are multiplying it by 2 because each primitive cell, effective number of atoms in a primitive cell is 2. So we are multiplying it by 2. This gives the volume occupied by atoms in the unit cell divided by total volume of the unit cell, which is A into A sine of 60 degrees into C, which is the volume of that primitive cell. Which is the volume of that primitive cell, A into A sine of 60 degrees into C, which comes out to be equal to 0.74. 0.74. If we substitute it for it, where C is equal to 1.663 A and A is equal to 2R. If you substitute for A is equal to 2R and C is equal to 1.663 A and A is equal to 2R, if you substitute and calculate it, you get the packing fraction to be 0.74. So in ideal SCP structure, 74% of total volume of unit cell is occupied by the atoms. In a ideal unit SCP structure, 74% of volume of unit cell is occupied by the atoms, isn't it? Atoms occupy 74% of volume of the unit cell, isn't it? So in terms of the packing fraction is expressed in terms of percentage. So this is called as the closed packed structure. In a closed packed structure, the packing fraction should be 0.74, isn't it? Which type of elements show such type of structure? Metals like magnesium, zinc, cadmium, tin exhibit this type of structure. I hope you have understood what is meant by a hexagonal closed packed structure. Now let us see a face centered cubic structure or FCC structure. A FCC structure or face centered cubic structure is shown in the figure. In this structure, the stacking arrangement of first two layers is same, isn't it? So same as that of SCP structure. First two layers, A and B layers, are same. The difference arises in the third layer, isn't it? So third layer in SCP structure is again A type, but here it is not A type. The difference arises in the third layer. In this case, the third layer, in the present case, does not overlap the first layer. In the SCP structure, third layer overlaps the first layer. In the structure, face-centered cubic structure, third layer does not overlap the first layer. The atoms of the third layer occupy positions of those valleys of A layer, positions of those valleys of A layer which are not occupied by B layer. I have shown you the there are some valleys, there are some valleys which are not occupied by B layer, which are shown here by C, which are shown here by C. So this in this figure, C represents the valleys which are not occupied by the B layer. So in this case, in the SCP type of structure, the third layer, the atoms of third layer occupy positions of those valleys of A layer which are not occupied by B layer. This layer is designated as C layer. This layer is designated as C layer. The fourth layer exactly overlaps the first layer. Now, the fourth layer of atoms exactly overlap, which is exactly similar to the layer arrangement of A layer. That is why the sequence, the stacking sequence, the fourth layer exactly overlaps first layer and the sequence is repeated. It is represented as ABC, ABC. So ABC, after that again it is repeated ABC type. So the fourth layer of atoms overlap the first layer of atoms. In case of SCP structure, the third layer of atoms overlap the first layer of atoms, and in case of FCC structure, the fourth layer of atoms exactly overlap the first layer of atoms. So here the stacking sequence is ABC, ABC types. I hope you have understood the difference between the stacking arrangement in SCP and FCC. The conventional unit cell is FCC, as shown in figure. It is a non-primitive cell. So in case of a primitive cell, the effective number of lattice points per unit cell is 1. And in case of a non-primitive cell, the number of lattice points per unit cell is greater than 1. So FCC structure is a unit cell is a conventional, it is a non-primitive unit cell having effective number of atoms per unit cell, 8 into 1 by 8 plus 6 into 1 by 2 is equal to 4, because 8 atoms are at the corners and 6 atoms are at the center of the face, which are shared by two planes. Isn't it? So 8 into 1 by 8 plus 6 into 1 by 2 is equal to 4. So effective number of atoms per unit cell is 4. The atoms touch each other along the face diagonals. The atoms in this unit cell touch each other along the face diagonal. You can see they are shown. They are touching each other along the face diagonal. Isn't it? If A is the length of the unit cell and R is the atomic radius, then they are related to each other by 4R is equal to under root of 2A. So here I have written capital R instead of small r. That is the typographical mistake. You try to understand it is the radius of the atom. 4R is equal to under root of 2A. R is the radius of the atom, A is the side of the unit cell, isn't it? So there is a relation we are going to derive in the next slide. So 4R is equal to under root of 2A. The packing fraction is given by F is equal to 4 into 4 by 3 pi R cube. Why we are multiplying it by 4? Because the effective number of atoms in a FCC unit cell is 4. So 4 into 4 by 3 pi R cube. 4 by 3 pi R cube is the volume of each atom divided by A cube, where A is the side of the cube. A is the length of side of the cube, which again comes out to be 0.74, isn't it? So the packing fraction in case of HCP structure and FCC structure are same because of close packed structure. The packing fraction is same as that of FCP structure because of close packed nature of both the structures. The coordination number of each atom is 12. The coordination number of each atom is 12. Now we will see how this 4R is equal to under root of 2A. So here a figure is shown. The atoms touch each other along the face diagonal. The atoms touch each other along the face diagonal. So the face diagonal is shown in figure by AB, capital AB. The atoms are in contact along the diagonal of the faces. Let R is the radius of the sphere. Then the diagonal of the face, diagonal length of AB here is 2R plus R plus R, radius of these three atoms, isn't it? A diameter of the central atoms plus radius of the two atoms. So 2R plus R plus R is equal to 4R. The number of spares in one unit cell is 4, isn't it? Just we have derived. The effective number of atoms per unit cell is 4. So in this figure, AC square plus BC square is equal to AB square. AB is equal to 4R. 4R square is equal to A square plus A square is equal to 2A square. Therefore, A is equal to A under root of 2A is equal to 4R. Under root of 2A is equal to 4R. Again, from this relation, the packing fraction is calculated here. So, under root of 2A is equal to 4R. So, under root of 2A is equal to 4R. This can be derived, isn't it? So, which type of element show such type of structure? Copper, Ag, Au, Al. All these elements show this face-centered cubic type of structure. So we come to the end of the topic, end of the video. In today's section, we have studied what are simple crystal structures. There are two types of simple crystal structures: close packed structure and loose packed structure. In close packed structure, we have studied two structures: hexagonal close packed structure and face centered cubic close packed structure. Isn't it? So we come to the end of the video. The subsequent articles will be studied in the next video. Till then, take care. Thank you. Thank you very much. Subscribe our channel. Don't forget to like our videos and comment our videos. And you can also share our videos with your friends. Thank you very much. Take care.